I'm a millionaire. Hey, yo, what's up, y'all? This your guy, Ernest Fields, and this is the very first episode of Grind Talk. We got Mr. Jason Daniels, the Titan himself in the building. What's good?
What's going on, my man?
You got Titan Electrical.
Yep.
You got the coaching class that you've been doing.
Yep.
Can you tell us about some of the other things you got going?
Yeah, man. So I started business coaching a couple years ago, and found out that I had really been a coach for a lot longer than I was actually utilizing my abilities and monetizing that avenue. People calling me all the time because Titan's Electrical was growing so fast, and we'll talk about that in a minute. But I started this business coaching program, and I started my own, which was Titan Success Academy, a little over a year ago. But I also got a business coach of my own, and over the past year, man, I developed a good relationship with him, really dig his system, saw how it was working in my life and other people's lives who are willing to work the program, invest in themselves, and really strive to reach their potential. So I asked him back in November. I said, hey man, so how can I get on board with utilizing the content you create? I mean, it works, so why I gotta go out and create something else to sell on my own?
Yeah.
How can I just jump in with you and ride in this lane with you, because it's working for you, and I think I can teach it to more people in my city and other cities that you haven't tapped yet. And so I went through a process and got certified in this business coaching program called Monster Producer, and we just kicked it off in Memphis last month, man. We filled the room with over 40 people, hungry entrepreneurs, real estate agents, insurance professionals, just people who want more. You know, they're doing well. They started a business. They're making some money. They're seeing some success, man, but they want something more. They want that edge. And so we come in and we give them that edge. And we kicked off good, man. We got 17 people participating in the Memphis area right now. I'm taking this to Dallas, and I'm kicking it off in Dallas in September. And then I'll be in Atlanta in 2018. And so that'll be my Bermuda Triangle right there. It'll be Memphis, Dallas, Atlanta. And my goal is just to build business professionals, build monsters as we call them, and help them succeed by giving them the right tools. They got the desire, they got the ambition. We just give them some extra tools they can put in their toolbox so that they can win at a higher level and be much more effective with whatever they choose to do.
Gotcha. So what are some of the key industries that some of the monster producers get a lot of people coming in to the producer program with?
Man, it's different in different cities. This all started in Middle Tennessee by my coach Michael Burt, and he fell in the vein of real estate and banking. And so in 2017, five of the top 10 mortgage originators in the state of Tennessee are clients, are monster producers. And so he's fallen in that vein, but I target small business owners. I took the program that he made and was using heavy in those markets, and I've turned it around and use it, because I'm not a real estate guy. I mean, I'm gonna get into real estate, but I'm not there yet, and that's not my bread and butter. And so I see how it works with small businesses, and felt like that might have been a market that was untapped for him. And so we have a couple real estate agents, man, but we have small business owners, people like myself. We got a kid that's starting his own TV show that we're coaching. We coach public speakers and people who write books. It's really all across the board, man. Anything, any type of business. Everybody feels like their business is special, right? You start your own business, that's like your child, just about, man. It's your little baby. Well, at the end of the day, when you break it down, man, it's the same nuts and bolts that hold that business together, that hold every business together. I mean, me and you could sit around and talk for several hours about how your clothing business is similar to my electrical business in the way that we depend on cash flow, how the money comes in, where the money goes out, what are these hidden expenses that we don't expect every time we try to scale and grow. And so we find those same things in every business, and it doesn't matter what it is that you're doing. It's just a natural foundation of every business.
So what are some of the things you were doing before you actually got into Titan Electrical, before you actually started the Monster Producer program? What were some of the things you were doing before then, prior to being an entrepreneur?
All right, so seven years ago I started Titan's Electrical, and prior to that I had several short-lived electrical companies, but I had partners, and we just didn't see eye to eye on some things, so I jumped ship on both of those companies before I got too far into it, and didn't see any success until I started on my own. But what brought me around to wanting to start my own business, and the reason I started an electrical business, one, electrical was the only thing I knew. I started doing electric work when I was 18, and it was what helped get me through and pay the bills while I was chasing the rap dream, man.
Yeah.
I was a hip hop head, man. I fell in love with rap music when I lived out west.
Who are some of the artists you work with while you were rapping?
Man, I did my last project. I recorded my last project over at Yo Gotti's house when Yo Gotti lived in Cordova, and me and him did a cut together. I started out when I was 17 years old. I was working at Sonic out there on Germantown Parkway,
yeah,
and was trying to get into Selecto Hits, which is the distribution place here in Memphis that 3-6 went through, and Skinny Pimp and Al Capone and all the Memphis folks.
That's who actually broke Master P them too, though, right?
Yeah. Gotcha. Selecto Hits was big in pushing Master P. I tell you what, when that Ghetto D CD came out, that orange disc, yeah, we had over 1 million copies in our warehouse, man, and I'm talking about pallets and pallets and pallets and stacks and stacks, and I was the cool kid at school because I had boxes of them for sale a week before they came out, yeah, you know. You know, Al Capone really put me onto a lot when I first started. I really didn't have any direction. I just knew I wanted to rap, and he allowed me to come on tour with him, go to his shows, get in the studio with him, and kind of see how that process works. So I really got a leg up when I first started. And then I spent my 20s just opening for other people, and I was in the scene, man. I got songs with Kia Shine. I was running around with the Rap Hustlers. I actually still have some business with Jack Frost from the Rap Hustlers.
Wow.
I'm meeting him tomorrow
because
he's into real estate now. Yeah. He lives in Atlanta, and my electrical company does all his work on his real estate property. So we both rolled out of the music game and moved into something that's more lucrative for both of us. But we still work together. We still do each other's work. I wire their tour buses. I do some of their the lighting on the sets and things like that. So I'm still tied into the music game, yeah, man. I still support it from afar, and you can't take those memories away from me, man. I had some good times running around chasing that dream. But I had a kid and got tired of sitting in the clubs till 3 a.m. getting the DJs to play my stuff. I got tired of not being at home. I was ready to really build a foundation of something strong I could stand on, and decided to start an electrical company, and then that led into really wanting to cast a bigger net and touch more people than just wanted electricity. I was like, who else can I impact?
Yeah.
Man, I think I need to go out and teach these businesses, teach these young, inspirational people, these people that just have a dream and a goal, but just don't know how to get there. I'm gonna help them fill the gaps, yeah, and help them, give them a better chance of success, because I done made all the mistakes you can make, and we got a system now that pretty much helps give you that edge.
So you said something that was kind of interesting to me. Basically, you said how you was working with these artists, and then you went out and started your own business, and now you actually come back and you still provide services to these artists, even in the alignment of the career, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I think this is one thing that an upcoming artist, somebody watching this, could pull from it, is that you can actually play a part in the industry, and you don't always have to be the person on the microphone. You may be the lighting guy, you may be the tour bus driver, depending on what your other expertise is outside of the music part. It all comes back and tie together.
Yeah, artists and producers always need trades. And let me tell you, man, once you become a person that's elite, a person in power, a person of influence that's really making money, you watch who you let in your house, man. Like Don Tripp. I wired Don Tripp's house. I did his security system. Anytime he needs something, he calls me. And you know why? Because he could trust me.
Yeah.
You know, you don't let you flip through the phone book or find somebody on the internet and you bring them to your house. You know, I do Mike Conley's electric work from the Grizzlies.
Yeah.
And he calls me because he can trust me. And so it's that relationship, man. So no matter what you're doing in your life right now, realize you may not be doing it for your entire life. Keep those relationships strong, man, because even if somebody's winning in a different arena, it doesn't mean that you can't do business together in a different space.
Hey, this is Ernest Fields. Right now, you tuned in to Grind Talk. We'll be right back after these messages.